Is the town of Fremont. It's been a tough past few days for Fremont firefighters. They've been working nonstop, assisting people affected by the floods, but last week, a few of those firefighters nearly lost their lives while trying to rescue a family. 3 News Now reporter Sydney Gray talked to the firefighters about how the experience has impacted them.
We were risking a lot to save a lot, and that's what we do.
This was the scene as multiple agencies worked to rescue Fremont firefighters who got stuck in flood water last week.
The conditions out there just change so rapidly.
Nick Morris and his crew were dispatched to a home that was quickly flooding. Basement walls fell before they made it to the home. But as the team was trying to rescue the family of five, their boats capsized.
It was real cold, real dark, and there's debris floating around between us. There was a lot of things to be scared of out there, but these guys all held it together.
After an hour in the water, a National Guard Black Hawk helicopter rescued the 7 men. Waiting at the hospital, Captain Pat Tawney says,
"That was extremely emotional to see your guys come in and shaking the way they were. It was pretty difficult."
And in soaking wetsuits, flooded boots, along with freezing cold hands, Morris tells us he wasn't sure they'd make it out.
"We were up against some tough decisions out there, and nobody should have to go through that.
When you leave your families and you go to work, you don't know if you're going home."
Long after the floodwaters have receded, the memories of that terrifying night will stick with these first responders for years to come. In Fremont, Sydney Gray, 3 News Now.
Fremont's local union president tells us situations like this